Are you struggling to focus for more than just a few minutes? Well, there's actually a system that was created in the 1980s which might help you. Maybe you've heard of it. Maybe you're watching this video because people have mentioned it and you're a bit clueless for what it actually does. So I'm going to very quickly, briefly, dive over the concept of Pomodoro timers and how they can be effective for your daily productivity. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Sensama. If you're interested in using a Pomodoro timer inside of a daily planner, then I'd highly recommend it. I used the Sensama app for many years and it's a great tool that is well worth checking out if you want a bit of mindfulness in your daily productivity. So what are some of the benefits before we dive in? Because so many people talk about Pomodoro, but what does it actually benefit in your day? Well, there's three benefits. It builds focus in short bursts, allowing you to have that intensity of focus whilst still staying on task. It gives you the opportunity to beat procrastination because it's planned procrastination instead of just random procrastination. And finally, it builds and creates momentum with breaks in mind. So you're not hammering on one thing at a time. So what is Pomodoro? So you work in focused intervals of traditionally 15 minutes. That's the idea. And you have a 5 minute break in between those 25 minutes and the next 25 minutes. And the idea is very simply, you do 4 cycles of that and you have a longer break. Each full cycle, a session and a break equals 1 pomo. And essentially you can collect pomos in your day to build up the idea that you're collecting things. Now, this was actually created by another Francesco called Francesco Cirillo, and he did it. And he called it a Pomodoro timer because it is like a traditional tomato shaped kitchen timer. But I don't know whether it's correlated to, I always knew Pomodoro the word when I was younger because my Italian grandmother used to call me that. Maybe it's because I looked a little bit rotund, I don't know. So just to recap that, how does it work? 25 minutes on, where you focus solely on the task at hand with a 5 minute break. That's a full cycle. You can do up to 4 cycles and then you take a 15 to 30 minute break to give you that breeze. And it's a great cycle that's very visual. Now, there are a few different things that can be used practically. For example, you don't have to rigidly stick to 25 minutes. You could adjust it 40 minutes, 50 minutes if you're in that focus and you need to work on something later. Use your breaks intentionally. So a lot of people, when they do the Pomodoro timer, get distracted by other things whilst they're doing that session, that 25 minute session traditionally. But the key is to not be distracted by that and then to use the break as your distraction so that it's like a planned distraction or a planned procrastination. And that idea of, you know, using that time to doom scroll or take a quick walk or hydrate, it's important. But you can also use that break intentionally too. So hydrating is a good one. Maybe a bad habit is doom scrolling, but at least you're planning that procrastination in versus doing it while you're trying to get the task done. Some people pair it with something called a shutdown ritual where you end the day in a more fine-tuned way. So you actually end the day looking at the pomos you've done and reflecting on them. You can do that in Sensama if you want. There's a feature where you actually finish up your day and plan the next day, and that can help to avoid burnout. So if you have that opportunity to do that, that's a great way to make sure your next day, the way you want to focus your next pomo sessions can really help. You can also time block as well. Time blocking is a great technique that will help you to visualize your next pomo sessions, and the timer can help you do that as well. So what might a Pomodoro session or cycle look like? So if you're trying to write a 3,000 word report, there's no point in setting out maybe 1 hour to just blitz it, because some people don't work like that. It might be a better way to break it down into a pomo session, and that might be part 2 Pomodoro cycles. So for example, you'd be 25 minutes on, 5 minute break, 25 minutes on, 5 minute break, and you're done. Maybe that's 1,500 words in the first session or 1,500 words in the second, or maybe it's 2,000, 1,000. But the idea is that you're breaking bigger tasks into smaller chunks that are more manageable. 3,000 words is a lot of time in 1 hour, so I do understand that. But it's a great way to really just plan your focus and get into the zone. One of the things that I found is if you're looking to use the Pomodoro technique at work, sometimes if you have your closest colleagues that are aware of you and they're comfortable with your productivity routine, using something visual on the table can be helpful. Say you've got a timer that's very visual, or something that will signify that you're in a focus state, or maybe it's even just flipping over something, and you let other people know around you that when you've got that on, you're in a deep work state, so don't interrupt you. That can be a great way to just give a little signal to those other people that you're in that state of work. Obviously, this is not always entirely practical in offices, but some people have found that helpful. So Pomodoros are designed for focus and structure. They're a great way to time, and they're a great way to enhance what you're doing. So it's well worth checking out, and I'm glad now, hopefully, you understand the Pomodoro system and how to use it. So big thanks to Sensama sponsoring. They do have a Pomodoro timer in their app. They also have time blocking and way more features when it comes to guided planning. So it helps you to structure your day more effectively. Thanks very much for stopping by, and I hope this video helped you. And I'll include more details in the link in the description. Cheerio for now.